Hello and welcome friends, one more new case of marginal costing, and this time we are going to discuss break-even analysis, CVP analysis, profit planning, etc. after merger of two companies, post-merger break-even analysis. What to do? There are fixed steps to solve this type of problem. First of all, read the question carefully and find out what is the capacity utilization at present, because sales and variable cost both are directly dependent on the capacity utilization percentage. Then first of all, calculate sales and variable costs at 100% capacity utilization for all the two or more companies under consideration for merger. And then we have to prepare a statement of sales, variable cost and contribution of the merged plant on the basis of the 100% capacity utilization. That will show what will be the amounts of sales, variable cost, contribution as well as fixed cost of the new merged single company or plant post merger. Okay, now first of all, let us prepare the statement. Statement for the merged company. For the merged company, we are going to keep the same format, and that will be rupees in million. Company 1, Company 2, as well as the merged company. Capacity utilization is 100%. Because merger of two or more company means merger of the whole capacity of the old plants or old companies. Because the merged company will not run at the existing capacity utilization only. All the assets are transferred to the merged company. So the 100% capacity of old companies is transferred to the merged company. So the 100% capacity of the new merged company will be summation of 100% or full capacities of all the old companies. This is the main point. If we do not consider this point, all the calculations would be wrong. Now, sales of the merged plant at 100% capacity will be sales at 100%, rather summation of sales at 100% capacity of all the plants. That will be sales into 100 upon capacity at present. See, 54 million sales is at 90% capacity. 54 into 100 divided by 90. So the 100% capacity sales of the first company must be 60 million. Similarly, 30 million sales of the second company is at 60% capacity utilization. 30 into 100 upon 60, that means its full capacity is actually 50 million. 60 plus 50, 110 million sales will be the 100% or full capacity of the new merged company. Similarly, variable cost. Variable cost at present into 100 divided by capacity at present. The same logic. 39.6 million is at 90% capacity utilization. 39.6 into 100 divided by 90, that means its full capacity. At full capacity, the variable cost must be 44 million. Similarly, 60% is at 60%, variable cost is 22.5 million. 22.5 into 100 divided by 60. What should be 22 divided by 60 rather 22.5 into 100 divided by 60, it is 37.5 million. 37.5 million is the variable cost at full capacity utilization in case of second company. Summation of these two is the variable cost at full capacity utilization in case of the new merged company. Yes, it comes to 81.5 million. So, the contribution, now we are interested in the merged company only. So, we will calculate the contribution of the merged plant only. What is it? Okay. 110 minus 81.5, it comes to 28.5. 28.5 million can be the total contribution of the new merged company. Now what about fixed cost? The main thing is fixed cost is not at all dependent on the capacity utilization percentage. In short term, the fixed cost remains constant from 0% capacity utilization to 100% or full capacity utilization. So, it will be 8 million plus 5 million, 13 million in case of the new merged company. So, this would be the scenario. We are not going to calculate profit at 100% capacity utilization. That is not important. It will create confusion. So, we are not going to calculate the profit. Now what? We have an important thing, fixed cost with us, and we can use contribution and sales to calculate the profit volume ratio of the merged plant, so that we would have the pair of fixed cost and PV ratio. Yes, 28.5 million is the contribution when we are making sales of 110 million. It comes to 0.259091. That is 25.9091%. We can take 25.91%. Because we are going to write all the figures in one decimal place only. 25.91% is the profit volume ratio of the new merged plant at 100% or full capacity utilization. In the next lecture, we are going to calculate the break-even point of the merged plant.